We're solving the Laplace equation, del squared phi equals 0, in two dimensions. So del squared is d squared dx squared plus d squared dy squared. We use the finite difference approximation to approximate the derivatives on a grid. And then we use natural ordering to order the values of phi from starting from 1, 2, 3, and so on across rows on the grid, starting from the bottom and going up to the top. Under natural ordering, the discrete Laplace equation became 4 phi sub k minus phi sub k minus 1 minus phi sub k plus 1 minus phi sub k minus nx, where nx is the number of grid points in the x direction, minus phi sub k plus nx equals 0. This is a matrix equation, and I want to show you then how to use this discrete Laplace equation to construct a matrix. So we're looking for an equation then that looks like some large matrix here. This will be nxny time by nxny size matrix. If it's a square matrix, it would be nx squared by nx squared. It's a very large matrix, times a column vector of our solution, phi, equal to some right-hand side, b. So that's our goal, is to write this matrix equation. To show you how this equation and boundary conditions, we also have boundary conditions, turn into a matrix equation, I want to do it for a small grid so I can write down the matrix equation explicitly and then show you how that generalizes then to a large grid, which you would use in your numerical solution. So let's start with a small grid. So the smallest grid where we have a reasonable matrix will be a 3x3 grid. So under natural ordering, it would be 1, 2, 3. So these are 3 grid points. And then we would have 4, 5, 6. And then we would have a 7, 8, 9. So these are 9 grid points. Here, nx is equal to 3, right? So 3 grid points in the x direction. And also ny here would also be equal to 3, okay? So it's a square grid. This equation here will only be valid for the interior point. In fact, there's only a single interior point here, which is the fifth point. So this equation is only for the fifth point. The boundary conditions are given for these other grid points. So in fact, here we have 8 boundary points, right? And at the boundary points, then phi sub k will be equal to some given value, and I'll call that b. And then we have 1 interior point. And the interior point then is going to be the value of phi at the interior point here, k equals 5. For k equals 5, we'll use the discrete Laplace equation. Okay, so let's write down the matrix equation for this. We need a very big matrix here. So let me try to write a big matrix here. The first row of the matrix corresponds to k equals 1, right? The second row will be k equals 2, and so on. For the first row, k equals 1, that corresponds to the equation for phi 1, but phi 1 is equal to b1, right? Phi 1 is equal to b1. So in the first row of this matrix, we're going to put the first row of the identity matrix. So let me put that here. So we have 1, right? There's It's 9 by 9, so we have 9 columns. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 9 columns, so this will be our size of our matrix. And then the unknown vector is our phi. So we'll have a phi sub 1 here. And then going down, we'll have a phi sub 2, phi sub 3, phi sub 4, phi sub 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. Okay, so this is our column vector of unknowns. And that's equal to our right-hand side. So our right-hand side is going to be the boundary conditions in the phi 1. So that means that phi 1 equals b1, right? Phi 1 is equal to b1. That's our boundary condition. And then phi 2 is supposed to be equal to b2. So that would get then the second row of the identity matrix. Let me just write that as I2. Phi 3 is supposed to be equal to B3. So that will be the third row of the identity matrix. I'll write that as I3. Phi 4 is equal to B4. And that will be the fourth row of the identity matrix, right? And then phi sub 5 then is satisfied by the discrete Laplace equation. So that's equal to 0, right? So how do we construct the fifth row here? Well, so 4 times phi sub 5, so that would correspond to the fifth column. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 gets the value of 4. So we get a 4 in the fifth column. So that means 4 times phi sub 5. And then we have minus 1, right? Minus 1 times phi sub 4, k minus 1. So we get a minus 1 to the left. And a minus 1, 5 plus 1, which is 6. So we get a minus 1 in the sixth column. So we get a minus 1 times phi sub 4 plus 4 times phi sub 5 minus 1 times phi sub 6. Then with nx equals 3, we'll have 5 minus 3 is 2, so a minus 1 in the second column. And then a 5 plus 3 is 8, a minus 1 in the eighth column. Okay? So then we would have a 0 here, and a 0 here, and we would have a 0 here, and a 0 here. Okay? So this discrete equation for the interior points would correspond to minus phi 2 minus phi 4 plus 4 times phi 5 minus phi 6 minus phi 8 equals 0, which is exactly this equation, okay? Then 6 through 9 are just the boundary values again. So we have an I6 row here. So I6, a seventh row of the identity matrix, the eighth row of the identity matrix, and finally the ninth row of the identity matrix. And the right-hand sides will be the values of those values of phi. So phi sub 6 is equal to b sub 6. Phi sub 7 is b sub 7. Phi sub 8 is b sub 8. And phi sub 9 is b sub 9. Okay? That's how we construct the matrix. The boundary conditions then get the corresponding rows of the identity matrix that simply sets phi equal to the boundary condition. The interior points then get the discrete Laplace equation. So here there's only one interior point. But when you have a large grid, say 100 by 100 or 1,000 by 1,000, then you'll have many more interior points than boundary points. And what you'll have then is a 4 going down the main diagonal of the grid, a minus 1 going down the diagonal one above the main, a minus 1 going down the diagonal one below the main, and then another minus 1 going down a diagonal that is the main plus nx, and a minus 1 going down a diagonal that's the main minus nx. So you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 diagonals in this matrix. Numerically, I would set up that matrix first with 5 diagonals using MATLAB built-in functions called spdiags. You'll learn about it when I talk about the MATLAB implementation. And then following setting up the diagonals of the matrix, replace the rows of the matrix by rows of the identity matrix in order to enforce the boundary conditions. Okay, that's the strategy. So let me briefly review. I wanted to show you that our discretization of the Laplace equation together with the natural ordering results in essentially a matrix equation for our unknown values of phi. It's a matrix equation with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 diagonals in it. And we use the fact that we can put rows of the identity matrix into this equation to as a simple way of enforcing the boundary conditions. I'm Jeff Chasnov. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.